Worship your holy name. And on that day when my strength is fading, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years Welcome this afternoon. On behalf of Margaret and Tracy, I would like to thank you for joining us today. We're here to mourn and to celebrate the life of our friend, brother, and son, Russell Wykes. Let us pray. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. We pray that you comfort and protect Margaret and Tracy, and family and friends. We pray that you give this family rest so they can mourn. We pray that you give them peace so they can know that Russell is now free from sickness and living with you in glory. We pray for all family and friends here today. Help them, Jesus. Help them come to know what Russell knew. That is a personal, real relationship with you, a relationship that sets us free. Amen. I'd now like to ask Meg to read a Bible verse.
Here we read today from Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life.
The Lord will watch over your coming and your going, both now and forevermore.
Thanks, Meg. Just like to invite the family first, and you don't have to, but we just want to invite you, if you'd like to say a few words, Trace or Marg first, or either of you.
Oh dear. Wow. You know, Russell and I didn't always get along.
You can take off your mask if you like.
We didn't always get along, Russell and I. We weren't the closest, but we were still close. And this is not what we expected necessarily. Well, at all, what am I talking necessarily, but at all. But thanks everyone for coming. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Trace. Did you want to say anything, Marg?
I left my words at home. But I just want to say that he's my rock.
No, I'm just...
Take your mask off, Margaret.
He was my... he was my rock. And he was my friend. And I loved him. But at the hospital, I saw him take his last breath. And that was comforting in a way. That's all. I'll miss him a lot.
Thank you. Thanks, Mark. I'd just like to invite anyone that would like to come and say a few words.
We've known Russell for about 11 years, and in that time he has been, and I've heard other people say it as well, he has been incredibly welcoming, incredibly kind. Like every time we had another grandchild, Russell would somewhere down the track buy them a present and deliver it to me to deliver to them. And he was really thoughtful, really engaged, wanting to engage, wanting to do life with everyone. And it's been our privilege to have known him and to have done life with Russell for the last 11 years, and to get to know him in that time and the family. And There's something that was really sweet about his heart and his spirit, and really kind to others. Mm-hmm. So that's how I remember Russell, and I know that I look forward to the day when we see him and we're all made whole. Mm-hmm. And what life will have been like for him now in glory. So, yeah.
Yeah, I've met Russell 11 years ago as well, and my favourite memory is having Bible study every Wednesday morning at Macca's with Russell. So today I thought I'd eat some Macca's before I came, and I was very reminded of those conversations we'd have at Macca's together, and I always loved Russell. He only hated me once when I told him to get off his phone for looking at pictures of women on the front desk. And he just looked at me and was like, oh, okay. But I always loved seeing Russ, and yeah, he'll be dearly missed. But Margaret, you've been amazing to him, and you were his world, and so was Trace. I know you fought like brother and sister, but that's normal. But you're amazing, Margaret, to do what you did, and he adored you. And we're here to support you during this time, because I know it's going to be hard, but we're here for you.
Anyone else like to share? One of the many memories I have of Russell, I had the privilege of taking him on two driving lessons And one of those lessons, I thought I'd be in there way before Russell. But one of the most beautiful parts of Russell that I loved, he would come to me every 3 or 4 months, and he would come to and say, "Pete, how do I get to know Jesus more?" And he'd say, "I just want you to give me a plan. How do I do that? What do I need to do? What should I be reading? What do I need to do to know him more?" And I just think of Russell, and I just think, see, Jesus knew Russell, and Russell knew Jesus. And there was this hunger in Russell to know him even more. And I look at that, and I look at many people in our congregation and many people in the world that we live in, and there's not many that are like that, that are just going, I know I know him, but I want to know him more. What can I do? How can I do it? What's the way to do this? And I loved that about Russell. He was always searching. He wasn't giving up. Even I remember after the second driving lesson I had with him, and he said to me, "So when are we going again?" And I said, "Russell, look, we need to do some. If you can't turn the steering wheel, if you can't take off the handbrake, I can't take you. So we need to do some work on those sort of things." And he was just determined to get it done. And even if it was hard for him, he'd still give it a go. Even though, you know, faced with oncoming cars, he still wanted to give it a go. And that, he had some real determination. And even to the point of Wednesday, the day before he passed, being in the room with him, and Russell was unconscious, and the doctor came in and said to Margaret and Trace, "I want you to know this is the end. I want you to know he's dying." Russell woke up and said, "I am not dying," and then went back to sleep. And I'm going, "Wow." How did he was determined to live. And a part of that, he was determined to live for you, Mark. For you. You were his best friend. You were the light of his world other than Jesus. And he loved you very much. Meg shared Psalm 121. This is probably my favourite psalm. But this is a psalm for you, Margaret, and for you, Trace, and for us here today. "I lift my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord." And that's what we're here for. We don't do this for us. Russ is already in heaven. We do this for us because this is a time where we connect with God and we connect with each other because we're here for each other. This is what church is about. This is what relationships are about. "I lift my eyes to the hill. Where does my help come from?" It comes from God. And if we can draw the strength from God, if we can draw the help from God, it enables us to help others. It enables us to help each other get through these difficult times. And he will not let your foot slip. He doesn't sleep. He doesn't slumber. He doesn't look at you and go, "Oh, look, I'm so tired of you. I don't want to have anything to do with you anymore." He never slumbers or sleeps. He's always looking after you. He's looking after you in the storms of life, in the heat of the day, in the night. He's with you. He will never leave you or forsake you. Every moment of every day. So I want to encourage you today. Draw from him. Draw from his strength. Draw from his love. Draw from what he's given you. And if you feel like you don't have anything to draw from one another. Draw from the strength in one another. Because that's the beautiful thing about relationships, is we're not all down at once. There's always someone there to help us up, to lift us up, to give us hope, to give us life. And the life giver is Jesus, but he calls us all to be life givers with him. So we're going to just do the photographic reflection now. And so just sit back and just watch some photos and some memories. Nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. For as much as it's pleased Almighty God to take unto himself the soul of Russell now departed, we bear his body hence to the place appointed for it, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. So thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. And may our trust be in him who said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though he dies, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. So God, we just pray that you pour out your love like a blanket over everyone right now. Comfort them. And in coming days, walk with them through the valleys into your peace. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege we all feel of being a part of Russell's life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. If we could just pay Amazing Grace, that'd be great. Thank you. Heavenly Father, we just thank you that you are real. We thank you that you comfort us. And we thank you that you give us all that we need. So, Father, just fill us now in Jesus' mighty name. Give us what we need in this time. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless you.